Hello and welcome to another episode of the +63HP Podcast Reviews Edition. I'm one of your hosts, John Clemente. Alongside with me are two of my bestest best friends. I'll start with the guy with the blue shirt, with a appropriately merchandised shirt. Trebox, how are you doing?
I am good. Happy to be back and happy to be discussing one of my favorite shows of 2022.
Same here. And then our other...
Wednesday.
Wednesdays. Adadums. Adadums. And another one of our bestest best friends, Arnie.
Hello there.
Woe is us. And as discussed in this particular episode of reviews, we are discussing the Netflix series Wednesday Addams Season 1. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. We are at youtube.com/plus63hp. Hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell so you can see and hear all of our shows across the week. You can also follow us in any of your favorite social media apps. We are at Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram with the handle at plus63hp. If you do not want to see us, if you don't want to watch this video on demand, you can listen to us on your favorite podcasting app. We prefer Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or Amazon, but feel free. Just search +63HP in any podcast app that you use, and we shall be there. Without further ado, we are going to discuss, I think unanimously, one of our really, really favorite shows of the year, Wednesday Addams. But before we get to Arnie's very, very quick recap, non-spoilery review of Wednesday Addams, what did you think about Wednesday Addams? And on initial outset, for those who haven't been convinced to watch it yet, we'll start with you, Arnie.
Well, I mean, if you're a fan of the original movies in the 90s, or even the original show, or just the property itself, it's a good adaptation and additional to the lore of the Addams Family. So, yeah, I recommend it. Highly, highly recommend it.
Chebox.
I love Jen Ortega. But I love this show. I love the cast.
I love Emma Myers too. I mean, not just Jenna.
I was surprised. I thought, like, I was worried that like Tim Burton wouldn't translate modern times, and I was surprised. I was really surprised.
Yeah.
Well, so, yeah. Perfect commentary. Again, I think I binged this in one sitting. I was so, like you, when I saw Tim Burton was associated with this project, directed most of the episodes, I thought that it was going to be too campy. I think there was going to be too just flash and pomp and circumstance and sets and whatnot, which I'm not a big fan of because I really need a solid story, regardless of how I love the series. So surprised. So fun. Great comedy, great action, great acting. Top of amazing costumes, sets, lore,
and characters.
Everything was
cast,
great.
Cast characters.
Cast was great. Everybody was endearing.
Yep.
Of course, Jenna Ortega crushing it. Crushing.
It's breakout role, man. Breakout role.
Amazing. So her alone is enough of a resource. So if you haven't seen Wednesday, watching Jenna Ortega alone for 8 episodes is reason enough. But all the other stuff, fucking Brienne of Tarth,
Enid,
love him. Gomez and Morticia Addams,
Zeta Jones, the thing.
Fucking hand was dope.
And
right,
Enid, right? Is it Enid?
Emma Myers,
killed it. Like even the sirens, even just the.
Nerdy B guy.
Yeah, but even the two snap thing made sense. Like had a use. Everything had use. I again super surprised. But without further ado, Arnie, run us through a quick synopsis so we can discuss about our favorite things about Wednesday Addams and our hope for season 2. Take it away.
Well, I think everybody knows it's one of Netflix's most streamed show this year, even beating Stranger Things 4. So most people probably have seen it. But basically, Wednesday just got kicked out of public school for protecting her brother, which is endearing, right?
For failing
to kill him. We saw that in the trailer. attempted murder or castration or something. So she ends up in Nevermore Academy, where it's basically a school for gifted children, basically.
Gifted.
And you have your typical cliques, you know, the vampires, the werewolves, the sirens, and what have you.
I love the pause. I love the double entendre about the stoners.
Because
Right? Because they're like the Medusa kids. I was like, oh, I fucking laughed out loud.
like,
Swear.
yeah, I got stoned last night. Like, yep,
Yep, you did.
yes, you did. And the thing is, like, because one would think, like, oh, it's gonna be another YA, you know, they're gonna be sorted or something like that. But nope, that's just the background, the backdrop, and it's a murder mystery, with a lot of twists and turns that, Wednesday had to go through. And like connecting Wednesday to the modern times, like, so of course when she arrived in the school, she's the only one with no cell phone. She's basically very old school tech, and she's like, yeah, it was basically good for her to be introduced to the modern world, basically. Even Uncle Fester was fun.
Oh my God, I didn't even know Uncle Fester could be that
Yeah, exactly. And then Thing. I wish there was more Gomez, but there was an arc there too that he was accused of murder, and then of course he was exonerated. The sheriff was another key character that, he's lawfully good, but of course he wants to protect his kid, and of course, spoiler alert, his kid was eventually the murderer or the serial killer that they were looking for. And yeah, I mean, there's a connection to the Salem witch trials or early colonial America, and then to the present. So it's just, and then of course Christina Ricci plays a character. Spoiler alert: she turns out to be one of the
The
villains and
mastermind.
the mastermind. And she,
I called that the moment that I saw it on the trailer. It's like, you're
really,
gonna
I mean,
have to,
like.
right?
For me, like, okay, she's a normie, which is basically a muggle. It's the Adam's word of for muggles is like a normie. Like, okay, and she's really very well adjusted, and then, I think she knows more than what she's telling us, so it does make sense. But like I said, it's a murder mystery. There's not a lot of things I could nitpick with the storyline. I mean, if at all, it's just not enough Adams family members, but that season two, they do promise to have more of Adams family, so stuff. So, yeah, but Jenna Ortega, wow, she needs to have her back checked. She carried the show, but then again, she has an awesome cast of ensemble cast to help support her in this show. So, not much I could say except that it was thrilling, what, eight episodes. I wanted to watch it in one sitting, but life gets in the way.
Yeah, awesome. Like again, it's one of those things where you're right, Arnie. It's like, oh, Jenna Ortega really carrying this. Why? I thought it was the Addams Family thing. Why are we concentrating on Wednesday? And then you look, you step back. Literally, the show says Wednesday Addams.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
exactly.
Again, me too. No, I nothing. There's so many layers to the story that are both enjoyable, endearing, but also make sense to the entire franchise. Like this town is reliant on this Nevermore Academy, which is a, you know, again, the school for the gifted or your people that have magic, et cetera, slash witches. And this town was the one that where they initially burnt witches, but you know, since the, you know, these magical people have a little bit more resources, it kind of sustains the town. So they kind of live in a little bit of like wink, wink, nudge, nudge kind of agreement of what they, you know, people trying to forgive each other's trespasses just so that, you know, the thing doesn't explode. So really
Exactly.
enjoy that. I the only again, you're right, the small nit that I had is among everybody, Pugsley is kind of like the most useless character in this particular franchise. But I don't know how you're going to make Wednesday badass without Pugsley becoming a little bit more. He's still
Weeks and
cool,
awesome. Yeah.
right? So we'll see on the second season. I love the roommate,
Oh, yeah.
The roommate
She's
relationship.
smothering me with love and attention. I like to repay her in her sleep.
I love the fact that everything that Wednesday Adam does is not slap you in the face feminism, but it's one of
Yeah.
those things where, oh, this is just becoming a person that knows herself so much that she doesn't care about what the other world thinks, right? So
Exactly.
it's very admirable. So I really
Yeah.
enjoyed it through and through. And then I this is one of the very, very few times when the last episode hit, I was like,
Yep.
fuck, I really want one more.
Yeah.
This can be a 20 episode season where every week is a monster of the week and Wednesday
Yeah.
Addams is kind of discovering it or uncovering it, and I'd be happy. And then, final point before I pass it to Box is like, I love the fact that, they made this the world in such a way like this could persist.
Yeah.
So, it was not a crappy open-ended cliffhanger end of a season,
Yeah.
but it was like more of like a, all right, you discovered how fucked up this town is, great, but there's more things to
Yeah.
come. That is very, very exciting for me.
Yeah.
Sparks.
Yeah, go ahead. No, go ahead.
I loved it. Like, especially the cello scenes. Like,
Oh, well,
she
yeah.
looked so amazing. Just the way
Yeah.
it was cut, the her look, her, and it,
Yeah.
I mean, she did train for it, so it lends it to even more credibility and just makes it more awesome. But I also love how in the dance scene, what else can you say? I also love how she's amazing, but she's not perfect. She's not Sherlock Holmes. She always
Yeah.
she makes
She makes
mistakes.
mistakes.
It's not really more mistakes. It's more like logical leaps that aren't
Yeah.
the correct one. It's, I mean, this is logical that,
Incomplete.
yeah,
It's
it's more, yeah,
incomplete.
it's like
Yeah.
logical reasoning from incomplete information. So
Yeah.
it makes sense. I also love that the casting was also good. So I mean, in hindsight, it's obvious that it's Christina Ricci, but they dropped enough
Misdirection.
roots, yeah, misdirections
Yeah.
that, I mean, it could be her. They already like
It could
affirmed
be
it to
the
be her. It could be
psychiatrist.
I
the
thought it was the
psychiatrist.
psychiatrist.
It could be the headmistress.
Yeah.
It could be the love interest. It could be the normie love interest. Like, that's the reason why
Yeah.
it's such a good thing. Like, it's good enough, but not like they're not gonna
Yeah.
like super fool you. So I enjoyed it.
And
I
I
just
think
feel
too
sad
is
that they killed Weems. I don't know, like, did they have to I
do
think it's
it?
I
I
just
think
think
it's gonna
they can't afford
they
they
probably
can't
couldn't
afford
afford
her seasons.
or
So I do
they
so
I hope
oh go ahead.
it leads to a bigger like not a bigger but a significant storyline
Replace
in the next season. Like there's an
I
I
every
think
season there's a new headmistress,
it's
like
kind of like with the Harry
a
Potter.
dark
There's
arts.
Dark Arts, but I
Yeah,
heard that
I would do
Angelica
it.
Houston is going to be the new principal. So the old
Oh
Misha.
shit. That
So
will be legit.
yeah,
I mean,
and
even Bianca was like, she's the queen bee, but she wasn't your typical queen bee. Like
yeah.
she wasn't really mean, she wasn't bad, she was just
Yeah.
like, I mean, she had instant friction with Wednesday because of Xavier, but aside from
Yeah.
that, I mean, we got
Yeah.
Eugene, I mean,
Yeah.
Isabella, my daughter loves this show. Like,
Yeah.
she's with me. We love Stranger Things. We love Wednesday, and
Yeah.
this is like the second to Stranger Things now, right? In
Yeah.
Netflix, in Netflix records.
Exactly. And I think I also like so when the twist that it was the love interest that's the serial killer, Wednesday, it's not your typical, oh, like she's so broken. I'm like, nope, okay, fine. You're a serial killer. Fine. I'll kill her. I'll stop you too,
That's
or
why you don't have
whatever.
friends, right? That's why she doesn't have
It,
feelings.
yeah, exactly. But the thing is, it's true to the character, and she doesn't need a love interest basically to be herself, right? So, it's feminism without
No,
being, I'll
and
hit
it's
you in the head
also
with it.
more
So,
of, it's also like baby steps. I mean, you can't really fall in love because she needs to make a friend first. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
she has to learn how to connect with someone first as a, at a friendship level before you can even go to the next one. So, and this one was mostly about her and Enid, you know, their friendship, their roller coaster, and they're finally, you know, hugging her at the end. It was like, oh, looks so good. It felt so good. Like,
And it's earned. It's the relationship is earned.
the good thing about this, and the reason why I love this series, is it's just a good series for teenagers and kids growing up to watch, because it has a lot of morals in terms of it's not a black and white thing where cliques are bad or not having cliques are
Emoji.
good,
Yeah.
Right, right. An
it's a
emoji.
combination of it's important to find your people, but it's also important to understand other people. Like
Yeah.
the, I
Don't
love
go
the
out of
fact
your
that it was
comfort zone.
exactly, and I love the fact that majority of the episodes were about cliques, like, you know,
The
the never what
sirens.
well, beyond the traditional high school cliques like that, but even the secret society clique, right? It's like, it's about that. It's Nevermore versus normal people. It is power without power, you know, that there's it's always this against the other. And then every time they say, like, the way that you solve a problem is either asking help or understanding the other side, right? Or just like falling flat on your face and making enough mistakes and have people help you go through them. Because it's weird that Wednesday Adams keeps on saying, like, she doesn't need anybody, she doesn't have friends, et cetera, et cetera. But the B guy was the first, he was immediate, she was already immediately like, yes, you're a friend of
Protective of
mine, so I'm
her.
going to help you out. Right?
And
So.
I think it also, like, especially with teens, it doesn't really glorify the gothy part of the franchise, right? So it's just like you're just a different girl, and there's different people, and you just try to work with each other, and you know how to be, because a lot of like gothy and it's a good
It's not overly dramatic. Again, I think
exactly
it's
it
so
it's
mature that it becomes more like teen driven. Like I just like I'm very impressed with how all of this kind of came together as like I think for me, like close to a perfect teen series, because they don't treat it as a teen series. They just treat it as a good story about
It's a
people
good
growing up.
murder mystery. It's a good murder mystery. I would like you could even put like a Knives Out skin on it. It's the same. It's a really good movie.
Good call, dude.
But yeah, I mean, it's again, what so we can't wait for season two. I hope they
And
announce
it's
it.
highly rewatchable. Like, I would
Oh
be in the
yeah.
background, because even
And
if
I'm
you know
sure
the
you'll probably catch
story,
something
you
else.
know, the lines are funny, it looks really nice, the colors are
And I'm sure
popping,
there's
you
probably
know, the
some Easter
music is
eggs too.
great.
And there's probably Easter eggs that you could probably see and all that, but you know,
Yeah, I
but
mean,
yeah, that's
and
it.
so it's a great. All right, let's keep it short and sweet. Let's do a round of reactions. Shabaks, final thoughts and your rating for Wednesday season one.
I'll go with a 9. I love this series. I can't. I just. This is the one where when I found out that they took 8 months to make the first season, like, oh shit, they're gonna take forever for the next. For season two, is like, I want more. I want more. I can't. What else can I say?
Before I pass it on to Arnie, I am gonna give one of my rare tens for this series. Like, I'm gonna
Fuck
give
it,
it
make it a 10. Make my
a
my I just I don't know why I might oh
Spoiler alert,
make it a
mine is
10.
also a 10.
You're right, you're
I'm
right. It's a
giving it a
10.
10
because, you know, first of all, Tim Burton surprised me. He can be very modern. I'm really appreciative about that. Again, great story. It's a great story for kids to watch. I think, you
Cara
know, if I
mia.
have kids in the future, this is the type of shows that I would want them to watch. Complex but understandable about being yourself, but not being yourself to the detriment of the others. And
Always a
then
balance, like you said.
a great balance, growth, understanding. I think I love that. But most importantly, I love how invested Jenna Ortega is with the character. I love people that, you know, these are iconic characters. Take care of them, because you know, people, I'm very distracted about very cool clothes, but like, yeah, it's yeah, I think it's one of those things where I wish more more people who take up franchises or thoughts like this take care of their characters, much like Jenna Ortega. Like, she, you know, everybody heard about she choreographed her own dance moves because, one, she wanted it to be authentically herself, but also she also wanted to be, she was very protective of how Wednesday Adams would be able to dance. And if you hire a choreographer and she danced very amazingly, that's not her character. How can you dance coolly if you don't dance? So I love this.
Exactly.
Rewatch it again, and then once I have kids, we'll probably, this is going to be a Halloween tradition. Arnie,
10 out of 10, same points that you pointed out. Yeah, I will put this with the Halloween, and same thing with the what's the Marvel one, and Werewolf at Night.
Ooh, that's a good call. Yeah,
that's a good combo, right? So, and again, yeah, Jenna Ortega, the Church Mouse, this is a breakout role. She's probably gonna get more projects. Hopefully, it's not gonna be like a Henry Cavill situation. but again, season two needs to happen. And yeah, I mean, if there's anything that they need to improve on, like Pugsley. Hey, I also want Lurch, dude, more of the Adams family. So they could be in Nevermore, or they could be at a home or whatever. And of course, always don't forget Enid. She's my favorite character.
Enid's the best. I love Enid. She's the best.
Yeah.
Conversion therapy for Oops, I was laughing out loud, but it's a heavy topic.
Yeah.
It's kind of like that's a good sign where you can laugh about heavy topics like this and understand what's about.
Yeah.
In which case, that's it. Thank you for watching. Sorry, I was gonna sneeze. Watch Wednesday Addams. Watch all of our shows. We have review shows on Mondays and Tuesdays. We have our D&D show on Wednesday, and we have reactions to trailers on Thursdays. We also have another D&D show on Fridays. Hit that notification bell so you know when these shows drop, and you can interact with us. We really appreciate all of the support. With that, we will see you in the next few weeks with more movies and videos to review with you guys. So this Straight Tens, watch it. Thanks again. Bye.
Bye.